Good morning, teachers and students and staff. This is Bad Year News. But before we begin with the daily announcements, please rise up for the morning routine.
Right hand
over your heart, please recite the play of the Legions.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic of which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now with that Texas
pledge.
Honor the Texas flag, I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible.
Finally, the battery screen.
I am somebody, the me I see is a me all me. I can be respectful, responsible, and resourceful. I can succeed. I make mistakes so I can learn. I learn so I can succeed. I succeed so I can help others. I pledge to show my respect by listening to others, caring about their feelings, and being responsible for what I say and do. I will follow the directions of my teachers. I will only say kind things about others. I will do my very best. I am in school to learn.
Please stand for a
moment
of silence. You may be seated.
Welcome back to a fantastic Friday. For today's weather, at a glance, expect sunny and
mild
temperatures. High for today will be 86 degrees Fahrenheit, and the low will be 60 degrees Fahrenheit. Expect rain for today is 2%.
We want to start off by wishing the following students a very happy birthday.
Gennady?
Alfaro Ramirez, Mateo Castillo, please go by the office to pick up your birthday pencil. And now for today's lunch menu,
pepperoni,
calzone, marinara, sauce cup, chicken salad,
croissant,
tossed side salad, sweet golden corn, fresh strawberries. Sounds divine.
Very good.
It's now my pleasure to welcome Ms. Martinez to announce any special announcements and reminders.
Very good. Thank you so much. Good morning, everyone, and happy Friday. My goodness, another week has passed us by, I'm sorry. And with that, I want to say a couple of announcements. We do have our Lunch Bunch AR Challenge for our first grade students, and it ends today. So students, first grade students, after the day ends today, we will be printing out the reports, And we want to see how many of you earned 10 points. Remember, it started last week. So we want to see how many first grade students met the challenge that they earned 10 points with an average of 80% or better. Also, a reminder everyone, today is the last day of AR. So please, 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 teachers, make sure to encourage your students to meet their goal. We want to make sure all of our students at Bruni meet the goal, okay? Remember, this information is also shared with everybody. They compare all the campuses, and not just because, oh, we're being compared to other campuses, no. But I know that we have readers here at Bruni, and we want to ensure that all our students are reading. Remember that reading makes you smarter. I love to see children read. I love to read myself, and I know lots of you teachers love to read as well. So you love to read on your own, and you love to read to your students. So take advantage of today and make sure that we encourage our students to read and take AR quizzes. Also, reminder, we are having three raffles. One, which will take place this afternoon. And remember, some of you bought tickets, okay, $1 tickets. And with that, a ribbon is posted outside your class, and you will be participating in a raffle, a basket raffle. And we showed you those baskets yesterday, the basket yesterday, and I know we've been showing them throughout the week. Just a reminder on that, today in the afternoon, before the day ends, we'll go ahead and announce the lucky winner. We'll have the drawing, and then we'll be having two more raffles after this week, okay? Just a reminder about that. Also, not only do you get to post a ribbon outside your classroom, or you get to participate in the basket raffle, the class, remember, the top lower grade class will win a pizza party, and the top upper grade class will win a pizza party as well. So three things, right, Ms. Lopez? Three things. You post a ribbon, you have a chance to win a basket, and then your class has a chance to win a pizza party, all for donating. And donating where? To the Relay for Life. This is a wonderful cause that our school is going to be participating in, and we are excited to contribute and help out this worthy cause. Okay, so thank you so much, boys and girls, for helping us with this. And another thing, just a reminder, third grade students and teachers, I will be conferencing with the third grade students today in the afternoon. I did send you an email regarding that. Teachers, make sure that your students' portfolios, their data portfolios or data folder is updated with their benchmark information. Make sure everything's highlighted, because I will be looking at them. Also, I had asked everyone last time when I met with the kiddos after the checkpoint to staple the little card that I use to conference with them, that it's stapled in their folder. I want to see that card, and then we're going to talk about our new goals for STAR, okay? So help me out with that. We will be calling you out, and we'll do it as we're going to go ahead and call you out by class, and then the next lesson, so on, okay? So just a reminder about that. And also, another important day, and this is for our little ones, our pre-K and kinder kiddos and their teachers and paraprofessionals. They are, after 2 years without this event, the All-Star event, our students are going to get a chance to participate in this wonderful event once again. So I know that they're very excited, and we're wearing, Ms. Arispe and I and the teachers and the students will be wearing these wonderful shirts, these beautiful shirts that they gave to us. And I can't wait to see everyone at Shirley Field. And I know our students are excited. The teachers have been saying that, oh, Ms. Martinez, the kids are excited to go on a field trip. So boys and girls, we want you to have fun. We want you to be safe and make sure that you represent our school. I know you're little, but I know you understand too. You're very smart. So I want you to be on your best behavior. You listen to your teachers so that whenever somebody sees our students from Bruni, they say, my goodness, those are the best behaved, right, Ms. Lopez, the best behaved students in the whole district, in the whole state of Texas. Okay? So, and we know you are. So we want you to be on your best behavior. You don't go anywhere without telling your teacher, okay? And I'll be seeing you over there as well. And then, just a reminder, this goes to all our teachers, that the 5th, 6 weeks, I cannot believe that the 5th, 6 weeks is already ending today. We will start our last 6 weeks on Monday. So with that being said, what happens after the 5th, 6 weeks? Today I will be sending you the failure report documentation because we are having report card day on Wednesday, next Wednesday. So this is a great opportunity if you have those parents, if you have those students that are failing and those parents are coming in, you make sure that you have that documentation ready and have them sign. Okay, I've been seeing a lot of teleconferences, and that's fine, but we also want to make sure that we take advantage if the parents are coming in, and I do recommend that you set up conferences, okay, because that's the proper thing to do. We were having, and we were allowing teleconferences because of the whole pandemic thing, but now we're encouraging you to set those face-to-face conferences. It gives it relevance, it gives it importance, not that they're a teleconference is not, but I feel that I feel that whenever we bring somebody in, you make it the time, okay? And parents understand, oh my goodness, she set up an appointment to meet with me during her planning or during report card day, so it must be very important, and this is something that I need to work on to help my child with, okay? So let's just keep that in mind always. And make sure to submit your grades, okay? No excuses. Grades are due today. And you need to make sure that all of that is in place. Make sure you have, it's not just assigning grades and finishing up. No, 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 because people can question you, okay? Parents can question you. I can question you. And if you don't have the grades to back it up, then that's not a good thing to do, okay? Those are not good practices. So we're teachers, we're ethical, and we, as long as you're ethical, as long as you do your job, that's all. You have your documentation to back it up, you're never going to have an issue with anything, okay? Always remember that. Okay, so super long announcements, but now I'm going to be reading a story just as promised. So I'm going to ask my kiddos that are helping us out with announcements to go sit down. I'm removing my face mask just because it's so hard to catch my breath while I'm reading, and I love reading to all of you. And I get so excited when I read. And we have to, right? Whenever we're reading a wonderful book, it's exciting and it's entertaining, and you learn different words, you learn about characters, you learn about the setting, the problem, right, the theme. You learn so many wonderful things. So this book is titled The Good Egg, and the authors are Jory Johnson and Pete Oswald. And you know what? I think they're also the illustrators. Usually it says illustrated by, but right now I'm thinking both of them collaborated together. Okay, they worked together, and they wrote the story and drew the pictures. And egg, because what are we celebrating soon? What holiday?
Easter,
that's right. Easter. So I said, okay, egg. It goes with Easter, right? We see lots of Easter eggs, right? Cascarones. In Spanish, we call them cascarones. ¿Ustedes pintan cascarones con sus papás?
Yeah.
¿Con su mamá o sus abuelitos? Sí, ¿verdad? A mí me gustaba cuando estaba chiquita. Me gustaba y poníamos los diferentes colores. ¿Y qué más teníamos que hacer?
Y luego lo teníamos que cargar en nuestra cabeza.
Bueno, pero antes, para prepararlos, ¿qué hacíamos? What did we do when we would prepare them, Denise? The confetti, right? El confetti, ¿verdad? Les ponías el confetti. Y luego, nosotros, ¿saben qué cortábamos? Antes usábamos periódico, okay? Newspaper. My grandma would have us use a glass around, you know, the top of the glass, lo de arriba del vaso, y luego los poníamos así en el periódico, ¿verdad? Y hacíamos los circulitos así. Los circulitos, todos, ¿verdad? Los trazábamos así y luego agarramos las tijeras y los cortábamos todas las varias hojitas, ¿verdad? Y poníamos a cortarnos. ¿Y saben cómo hacíamos? We wouldn't use glue. We would use something else. Nosotros usábamos algo más. Mi abuelita hacía, y mi mamá también, hacía como una pastita, pero con agua y harina. Agua y harina. So la hacías y se hacía como gomita tipo, ¿verdad? Like a little paste. And then we would put some, we would grab the little egg like this, right? And then I would put my little, I would dip my little, my fingers inside the little paste. Los así, le hacía así con el, mis dedos, ¿verdad? En la pastita de harina y de agua. Y luego le ponía así, ¿verdad? Y lo agarraba la, ya que le echaba el confeti, ¿verdad? El cascarón, ya que estaba pintadito así bien bonito. Le ponía la tapita, era como una tapita, ¿verdad? Y luego ya los poníamos ¿cómo se dice? En the carton, the egg carton. Pero ¿cómo se dice en español? En el, ay, no sé cómo
la
se
dice. La caja de huevos.
Pues donde, la cajita de huevos, ¿verdad? Sí. Los poníamos así, luego ya estaba una docena. Y luego otra. Okay, so how many things in a dozen? How many things in a dozen? Cuando dices una docena, ¿cuántas cosas hay en una docena?
Ah, pues, hazte cuenta que yo pido chocolates, ¿verdad? Uh-huh. Hay una caja de chocolate.
Bueno, sí, pero how much is a dozen? ¿Cuántos hay en una docena? ¿Cuántas cosas hay en una docena? Cuando decimos una docena.
12.
Muy bien, 12. 12 things in a dozen, okay? That's how many things, whenever you hear a dozen, it's always going to be 12, okay? Mm-hmm. When it's half a dozen, what do you think it is? If it, a full dozen is 12? Six, very good, Anthony. Okay, so I want you to sit back and enjoy this wonderful story. Again, this is a beautiful story, and you're going to see that it's not only relatable to you children, but it's also relatable to me. I read it and I was like, Miss Lopez, oh my goodness. And Miss Lopez shares her books with us, okay? I go into her room and I borrow books. She has lots of books. Miss Lopez was a teacher too, so she has lots of books, and she would read to her kiddos when she was a third grade teacher. So I told Miss Lopez, I like that story. I can relate to it, and you're going to see why, okay? The Good Egg, and this is an AR book. I'm sorry, I get so excited and I start talking about other things, but I'm making connections, right? We're making connections. So the level is 2.3 and the quiz number is 500-400. So make sure, teachers, to write it on the whiteboard. 500-400, that's a quiz number, okay? Sit back and enjoy. Okay, hello. I was just rescuing this cat. Know why? Because I'm a good egg. So who's a good egg? Him, right. Look at him. A very, very good egg. He's saying, I'm a very good egg. Are you good? I think all children are good, right? It's true. I do all kinds of good things, like I'll carry your groceries, I'll water your plants, I'll change your tires, I'll paint your house. If you need any help whatsoever, I'm your egg, he says. Is that a good person, a good egg?
Yes.
Yes, right? If you were to do all these things, would you be considered a good person?
Yes.
Yes, right? Because you're always helping somebody. I've always been a good egg. It's been this way from the very start, even in my earliest days. And he's here, look, when he's a little baby. Back at the store, he says, there were a dozen of us living together under one recycled roof. And do you see the carton of eggs?
Yes.
¿Verdad? And how many? Let's count.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
12 in a dozen. Remember we talked about that? There was Meg and Peg and Greg and Clegg and Shell and Shelly and Sheldon and Shelby and Egbert. Egbert, I'm sorry, and Frank, and other Frank. The other 11 eggs weren't on their best behavior. They weren't exactly good. Oh my goodness, look at all those rowdy eggs. Se portan muy mal, miren. They ignored their bedtime. They're supposed to go to bed at 8, and they wouldn't go to bed at 8. They would go to bed at 11. Is that good for children? No, right? They only ate sugary cereal. They're like my sons. My sons love sugary cereal like Captain Crunch and Apple Jacks and Frosted Flakes, right? They threw tantrums. Look at them. Cuando se tiran al suelo y están llorando. They cried for no reason. They broke their stuff on purpose. Are those good eggs?
No.
No, no, no. Meanwhile, I tried to take charge. I tried to fix their bad behavior. I tried to keep the peace because I was a good egg. So here you see good egg trying to help do everything and making sure that they're following the rules and making sure that everybody's doing what they're supposed to do. I was a very, very good egg. Poor egg. Nobody seemed to care though. Every night I was exhausted. My head felt scrambled. Sometimes I feel like that. At nights I can't sleep because I worry about everybody at our school. Imagine 400 and some kiddos, and then plus all the teachers and the paraprofessionals and the custodians, and then I have to worry about parents. My goodness. And my head feels scrambled and I can't sleep. I can relate. That's why I told you that I could relate to poor egg, right? Do you feel like that sometimes when you're worried about things? Right? Then one fateful morning, I noticed some cracks in my shell. They were everywhere. And look at him. Do you see the cracks?
Yes.
He's like, what's happening to me, Luke? It's like me when I notice like little wrinkles and little gray hairs, right? I'm like, and she's like, yikes. And somebody posted a sticky, look. It's, what does the sticky say?
Kick me.
Kick me? Who do you think it was? Los malos, ¿verdad? Los que se portan, no que son malos, pero se portan mal. Miren los pinguitos que andan ahí colgándose. Pobrecito. Ay, no. Qué mortificación. My doctor said it was from all the pressure I was putting on myself. The pressure of making sure everybody was good as me. It's like, look, doctor, I'm so stressed out. And they're injecting yolk. La yema. Le están inyectando, pobrecitos, lo que necesita. I was cracking up, literally he was cracking up, right? Look at all the cracks. He had to, look, the doctor had to put some band-aids on him. Something had to change. I had enough. He's like, something's gonna change. I had enough of this.
He's turning bad.
He's taking charge, right, of his feet. Let's see what he's taking charge of. Maybe his feelings? Maybe, right? I told Meg and Peg and Greg and Clegg and Shell and Shelly and Sheldon and Shelby and Egbert and Frank and other Frank that I was leaving. He's like, you know what? I can't anymore. I can't deal with this. I can't be the only good egg in a bad carton, I said. Blah, 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 they replied. Lo ignoraron y le hicieron burla como, stop it. We don't want to hear you anymore. I left that night and look at him. Remember what I said about illustrations? Do they help you understand? Yes. How does he look?
That's sad.
Sad, right? Disappointed and sad. I wandered from town to town. The hours became days. The days became weeks. I lost track of time. And he grew a beard. Le creció la barba. Donde andaba caminando por todas las partes con... I was alone. Ay, look, he's using some rocks to draw his friends. Miren, porque se sentía triste y solo. Out there on the road, under the stars, I really tried to focus on myself and what I needed. But you know what? While he was walking and wandering, he was thinking and reflecting. Okay, you know what? I need to focus on myself. I need to take care of myself. You need to do that too sometimes, right? Sometimes you need to say, you know what? I need to go to a quiet place and have some me time and do things for me, right? Yes, so that's what he's doing. And he looks, he looks like he's resting and relaxing. I took walks, I read books, I floated in the river, I wrote in my journal, I found simple moments to be quiet. I breathed in, he's like, I breathed out. I even started painting. Painting's relaxing too. Yeah, I like to paint.
I paint.
You do? That's good, that's relaxing. For once, I found time for me, he's saying. And sometimes you need to step back and find time for yourselves as well. Look at him, he's at the spa with cucumbers on his eyes. I wish I was that egg. And guess what? What do you think happens after you spend time on yourself? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? Denise, ¿qué pasa?
He's not frustrated anymore and his head...
He's not frustrated. He's not having all those thoughts, right?
Uh-huh.
It's helped him. Little by little, the cracks in my shell started to heal. My head no longer felt scrambled. He's like, all of this helped me. Is that, that's a good thing, yes. I started to feel like myself again. And there you see him sitting down. Like when you do yoga, you're like, zen. You're like this, right? That's the way he was. So I've made a big decision. I'm returning to my old garden and my friends. Besides, I'm kind of lonely out here. This time I know what I need to do. I'll try not to worry so much. I'll be good to my fellow eggs while also being good to myself. That's what he's thinking. Now, he learned. He's like, you know what? It's okay. Let me go back. I'm going to be good to my fellow egg friends, but I'm also going to be good to myself. And that's what sometimes we need to do. We can't control everything. We need to let things go, but we need to take care of everyone, help everyone, and take care of ourselves as well. Here we go, okay? Everybody missed me, and I miss them too. Look at his friends. They're like, welcome home, Egg. Hello, Meg. Howdy, Peg. Hey, Greg. Greetings, Clegg. What's up, Shell? Aloha, Shelly. Hey, yo, Sheldon. Hi, yo, Shelby. Good day, Eggbird. What's happening, Frank? Howdy do, other Frank. And he's like, hey, everyone. So many friends, right? How many friends does he have?
11.
11. Good, because
he's one of them.
So it's 12 and a dozen. Good job, Anthony. Sure, every once in a while, somebody's still a little bad, but it's not like before. Here's what I realized. The other eggs aren't perfect, and I don't have to be either. I'm okay with that. You don't have to be perfect, right?
Yeah.
And we can't expect everyone to be perfect, so we just try our best, as long as everybody tries their best. And it's also okay to have fun, right? And look at Good Egg. Is he having fun?
Yes,
he is. Yep, the old garden is back together. We're a solid dozen again. It's good to be home. Even though the other ones, miren, está dibujando aquí some underwear. Oh my goodness. And they drew on him too. They colored him. But it's okay. The end. I hope you enjoyed the story. Remember to take the AR quiz. It is an AR book. It's 500. 400 is a quiz number. Come back, my love, so we can close up.
That is for today, but before we sign off, we would like to leave everyone with the following thought. At Bruni Elementary, we are always a great game. When it comes to following the rules, be respectful and be responsible. Go on and make this a wonderful learning day. And always remember, we are stronger together. Today's announcements are brought to you by Karen Castañeda,
Anthony Villalobos,
and Denise Acosta
from Miss Mercado's third grade class.